People also ask snippets can be a great way for you to build up your organic traffic, especially when you don't have a lot of domain authority. So in today's video, I'm gonna be sharing with you a free tool that you can use to find these snippets for you and then easily start prepping your article briefs. This is gonna be way faster than just going through Google itself. And so let's go ahead and dig right into the tool. All right, so I'm gonna actually leave the link to the tool in the video description below, but essentially this free tool breaks down all the people also ask phrases that are most common for some of the phrases you're trying to rank for. So the first thing you wanna do is on the left-hand side, you're gonna see the section for where you're gonna wanna select your language. And then you're gonna want to go ahead and type in the phrase that you are trying to look for people also ask snippets for. So in this situation, I'm gonna look for something I've done recently, which is soccer midfielders. So I'm gonna search for the phrase soccer midfielder, and I'm gonna zoom in a little bit just so you can see that. And then once I'm ready, I'm gonna select the country, which is gonna be the United States for me, and then I'm gonna select explore. From here, what's gonna happen is this tool is gonna go ahead and extract out some of the common people also ask questions that are related to the phrase that I've input. So in this situation, if you wanna zoom in here, you can see that it's pulled out phrases like, which soccer midfielder are you? What do soccer midfielders do? What does a soccer midfielder do? What is a soccer midfielder? What makes a good soccer midfielder? And so on. So the reason why this is super cool is because it essentially creates this list that you can either just download as a CSV and then pull it into your article brief, or it just gives you the basis of some of the headers that you might use when you're prepping an article brief to either start writing the content yourself or to delegate it off to somebody on your team for a content writer, for example. So this is really helpful because it saves you time from having to just expand out all of the people also ask snippets yourself. Let's go ahead and take a look at what you might do if you weren't using a tool quite like this. In the case where you didn't have a tool quite like this, what you might find yourself on is Google itself and then searching for soccer midfielder. But the challenge that you'd have here is that if you were to look on the left-hand side here for people also ask, you have all these different phrases, but it's not really easy for you to extract these out. Sure, you can use a scraping extension or something like that, but what I love about this free tool is that you can just click the download CSV button and then you already have the file ready for you. So this is a great way for you to do a lot of different research. You'll also notice on the left-hand side that there's a helpful section which talks about the interrogative words that you can filter through. So in the case, for example, I've already covered all of the what phrases, I can just exclude that and then research the respective phrase. And then from there, it will exclude the what related people also ask snippets that come up. This is super powerful just because it can be a great way for you as well to think about the different keyword clusters that you might be able to tackle if you already had some successful posts. So let's say, for example, we have a particular thing around soccer gear. And maybe we've already covered the what phrases around soccer gear, so we can exclude that. And maybe we just want to figure out exactly what are some of the how much questions that we want to tackle with respect to soccer gear. And so if you were just to filter down for the how much interrogative word, you'll notice how the results will essentially output the things that connect to that interrogative word, as well as the keyword around soccer gear. And then it outputs questions like, how much is soccer gear? How much does soccer gear cost? Soccer gear prices, and so on. So this is a really useful way for you to really exhaustively cover a particular topic that you might be doing keyword research on. And it's all free right now. So it's something that you can definitely use when you're trying to harvest these people also ask phrases that can get you a lot of traffic. The reason why this can be so powerful is because a lot of times Google is willing to actually let smaller websites rank for these long tail phrases that people are asking questions around in the case where you provide really quality content in answering that particular question. There are tons of different question phrases that Google is looking for the answers to, and so they will often give these sorts of different niche websites a chance at fulfilling the intent for these phrases. But just to prove that for you, let's take a look at this phrase around soccer midfielders or soccer gear to see what sort of sites Google is giving top placements to right now. Before we look into the different sort of sites that Google is giving top placements to for these soccer related phrases, if you're getting value out of this video, hit that like button below. All right, so if you were to take a look at some of these search results for soccer midfielder, you can see how if I expand out some of these respective questions, it's coming up with a variety of websites from Dick's Sporting Goods to websites like thesportsbrief.com, Wikipedia, as well as attackingsoccer.com, which if I were to guess is a niche site, it definitely is. You can just tell based off of the sort of content on this respective website. And so here you can just tell that Google has a variety of interests in terms of fulfilling the intent of these particular questions that people are asking for. And we can look at this in the same way if we were to look up something like how much soccer gear. So in this case, you'll see that here are some of the people also ask phrases that people are asking. And as you expand this out, what you'll notice is that it's again a variety of websites that are getting the top placements for these questions. There's things like mastersoccermind.com, Get Hype Sports, as well as soccer.epicsports.com. And if you were to look at these particular websites, you can tell that this is another niche website. This is something in which somebody is providing a lot of different best of content, as well as tips and advice for different players. And then you'll also notice on this Get Hype site that this is similar in that they are creating guides for both sports and gaming. So these are all very similar websites, but and they all find themselves in the soccer niche, and yet they're all able to rank for different people also ask phrases that people are looking for. So there you have it. I hope you enjoy this free tool and that you can get a lot of use out of it in the case where you don't have paid SEO tools that you can afford right now. If you got value out of this video today, hit that like button below, subscribe for more content like this, and then check out my video over here where I go over another SEO tool that you might find useful in your keyword research.